In this problem, we're given a rotational Atwood machine. So we have a heavy disk with a mass of big M and a radius of big R. Underneath that is a light hub with a radius of little r, and there's a string wrapped around that hub. The string is then draped over a pulley and attached to a hanging mass of little m, and the system is released from rest, and as m falls lower and lower, the disk speeds up faster and faster. And we're answering a few different questions here. The last part, which is actually on another slide, is that we want to find the final angular velocity of the disk after this hanging mass has dropped through a distance of d. And we've actually solved that problem before, but we used the energy approach to the problem to get that done. And I'll post a link to that energy conservation approach up at the top. And what's different in this problem is we're going to approach it by using forces and torques to solve everything about the system. And we'll get the same answer for the final angular velocity. That's actually part C of the question. But using forces and torques gives us more than that, because in part B, we're going to find the acceleration of the hanging mass and the tension in the string, and that's something the energy approach can't do. So in part A, we're asked to set up a system of equations for the tension and the acceleration by using a force and torque analysis. So basically what we're going to do here is apply Newton's second law to the hanging mass and do a force analysis there. And then we're going to apply the rotational equivalent of Newton's second law, that's tau equals I alpha, to the heavy disk. This should give us a system of two equations and two unknowns, where the two unknowns are the tension in the string and the acceleration of the hanging mass. So we'll get things started with that little hanging mass. That's the easy part. And that little hanging mass feels two forces. It has the weight, mg, pointing down, and the tension in that string, t, pulling up. Note that I took care to draw the tension vector shorter than the weight vector, because we know this mass is accelerating downward. So T is not equal to mg, it's actually less than mg. Now we apply Newton's second law, and we're going to choose a coordinate system where the actual direction of acceleration, we're going to call that positive. So we're going to call downward positive for the analysis here. So I get mg minus T is equal to ma. That's just F net equals ma. And by choosing this downward pointing coordinate system, we're guaranteeing that A is positive, which really makes a lot of the math nicer. Next, we have to get into the analysis of our big M disk. So what we're applying here is the rotational equivalent of Newton's second law. That's tau equals I alpha. Tau is the torque on the disk. I is the moment of inertia. And alpha is the angular acceleration. And there are a few things to clarify about what's going on with the hub that'll be useful in different parts of the problem. So let's bring in an overhead view of this hub with the string coming off of it. So here's our overhead view of the hub, and the string is coming off that, causing the hub to spin and therefore the disk to spin. And the tension in this string is still the same T that's pulling up on the little M. And notice the string always comes off perpendicular to the lever arm here. In other words, that little line segment that connects us to the center of rotation. And so the first thing I want to say is that the torque exerted by this tension is going to be T times little r, where little r is the radius of the hub. Now it's also going to be useful to have a reminder of the relationship between the linear motion of the string and the rotational motion of the hub. First, the speed that the string is moving, which by the way is the same as the speed of the falling mass, is going to be given by r omega. So that's the relationship between the speed of the falling mass actually and the rotational speed of the hub, which is the same as the rotational speed of the disk. We can also take a time derivative of this and find that the acceleration of the string, which is the same as the acceleration of the little mass, is given by r times alpha, where alpha is the angular acceleration of the hub and disk combination. So actually, all three of these things are going to be useful, but the first one we're going to use is to replace tau with t times r. Now, the moment of inertia is given by the usual formula for the moment of inertia of a disk. That's 1/2 mr squared, where that's a big M. And I'll post a link at the top to the video where that was first derived using calculus. Okay, and then we have the angular acceleration alpha, but we want to write that in terms of the acceleration of the falling mass. So that's where we use this third relationship that we found. And alpha can be replaced with A over little r. So now we can go ahead and solve for T, and that's a nice way to leave this second equation for the moment. And T is 1/2 big M times big R squared over little r squared times A. So now we've got our system of equations for the tension and the acceleration, and this can be quickly solved by substitution. The second equation is already solved for t, so I'm just going to sub that into the first equation, and we should be able to solve for the acceleration of the hanging mass. So we get mg minus the tension, which is 1/2 big M times big R squared over little r squared times a. That's equal to ma. So now we can move the two a-containing terms to the right-hand side of the equation and factor the a out. So on that right-hand side, we end up with an a times the quantity little m plus 1/2 big M times big R squared over little r squared. Now it's going to be useful to collapse that into a single fraction. So the denominator of the term on the right-hand side is actually 2 little r squared, and the numerator is big M times r squared. So we need a common denominator, and we multiply this little m by 2 little r squared divided by 2 little r squared. This allows us now to add these two different fractions. So the numerator of the first one is 2 little m r squared. The numerator of the second fraction is big M big r squared. And the common denominator is 2 little r squared. Now we can solve for a by multiplying by the reciprocal. And we end up with a equals 2 little r squared little mg divided by 2 little m little r squared plus big M big r squared. Now to get t, we just plug back into this second equation that we originally got in part a. So I have to take 1/2 big M big r squared over little r squared and multiply this acceleration by it. I'm going to go ahead and express this first part as a single fraction. So big M big r squared over 2 little r squared times a, which we just found is 2 little r squared little mg divided by 2 little m little r squared plus big M big r squared. So the r squareds are going to cancel out here, and the 2s are going to cancel out, and I find that t is little m big M r squared g over 2 little m little r squared plus big M big r squared. So now we have the acceleration of this falling mass and the tension in the string, and those are both things that we could only get by doing this force and torque analysis. And now we're ready to use this acceleration to go ahead and find the final rotational speed of the disk after the mass has fallen through a distance of d. So the idea here is that we have the acceleration of that hanging mass and the distance it accelerated through. We should be able to find the final velocity. And then the final velocity of that mass is the same as the velocity of the string, which is the same as the velocity of the edge of the hub. And then we can relate to the angular speed using v equals little r omega. So we're going to start with a kinematics equation here and say v squared is v naught squared plus 2a times d. And the system starts from rest, so v naught is 0. So I end up with v squared equals 2d times this acceleration that we found. So my numerator is going to be 4d little r squared little mg. The denominator stays the same. It's 2 little m little r squared plus big M big r squared. And then all I have to do is square root this, and I have the final speed of my hanging mass. And now finally, omega final, the final angular velocity, is going to be this final speed of our falling mass divided by little r. So if we divide this expression by little r, that's the same as dividing the inside of the square root by r squared. So the r squared is simply going to vanish. And I'm going to rearrange the terms in the numerator a little bit. I'm going to write this as 4mgd. And that's just to make it look a little more like the same solution that we got using energy conservation. You might recognize the mgd there as a potential energy term. And our denominator is 2 little m little r squared plus big M big r squared. So there's the general solution of this rotational Atwood machine by using forces and torques. Now, if you're interested in seeing the energy conservation approach to this part C, I'll post a link to that video at the upper left of the end screen, and I'll see you there.